Lecture on power system stability presented by Professor Prasanna Kumar, Professor, Hennepo Institute of Technology, Moodibidre. As the name suggests, stability. Stability in the sense the system to be stable under certain disturbance in the power system. In power system, there are so many components and so many disturbances are going to happen in a power system. The disturbance may be due to foreign objects coming in contact with the barrier power system lines, or maybe insulation failure, or maybe human switching operation. All these things which is going to result in disturbances, and even it result in finally in short circuit. Hence, there are so many components in the power system, it becomes unstable. Here, stability is one of the fact. After these things going to happen, like disturbances, the system, for the normal operation, the system to be become stable. Hence, this concept which makes you to understand how the system becomes stable and what are the different types of stabilities and why, what is, the, is going to exist in the power system and how we can handle and overcome these stabilities. Here we will go with the definition. Stability of a large interconnected power system is its ability to return to normal or stable operation after having been subjected to some form of disturbance. Conversely, instability denotes a condition of loss of synchronism in the system. This will result in wild fluctuation of currents and voltages within the power system network, which is obviously undesirable. This tells about the need of stability classification. Why we need stability analysis is here. Also, it leads to proper and effective understanding of different power system instabilities, like maybe in the transmission line, or maybe the terminals of the generator, or maybe other appliance which is connected to power system. Key factor that leads to instability can be easily identified. Methods can be devised for improving power system stability. This slide shows the different classification of power system stability. It is broadly classified into steady state stability, transient stability, and dynamic stability. As the name suggests, steady state stability. Steady means the system is stable for a longer duration. Transient is nothing but only for a shorter duration. Okay. And dynamic stability is almost similar to steady state stability to get into a steady state period here. First, we'll let you understand steady state stability. It is ability to regain normal and stable operation after being subjected to gradual or slow change in the load. If there may be a gradual sudden change in the load, or maybe gradual slowly or very slow change in the load, the system is going to be stable. Concerned with upper loading of machine before losing synchronism, load is assumed to be applied at a rate which is slow. System is analyzes by the set of linear equations. Transient stability and dynamic stability. Transient stability is nothing but transient condition is nothing but a condition at the time of fault occurrence here. Okay, it is very severe. The magnitude of current becomes so high, and this problem to be made stable. The concept here we call it as transient stability. Ability to regain normal and stable operation after being subjected to sudden and large changes in the load. There may be sudden change in load, or maybe large changes in the load. Large changes in the load, it may be a huge load going to be applied, or it may be completely load is going to be removed at an instant. At that time, the magnetic current goes so high that regards in instability, but the system you have to make it is stable, that we are calling it transient stability under these circumstances. Losses, generator, excitation, transmission, switching operation, and faults. Action of voltage regulators and future governor are not included. Dynamic stability is nothing but same as steady state stability, included action of turbine governors and voltage regulations. This shows classification of power system stability. It is broadly classified in rotor angle stability, frequency stability, and voltage stability. And it's very clear from that rotor angle stability, it is into two categories: small disturbance angle stability and transient stability. Transient stability is nothing but only for a short duration, small disturbance angle stability. But both these, transient stability and small disturbance angle stability, which comes under rotor angle stability, it is going to exist for a very short term. It's going to exist for a very short term here, as already shown here. Okay, it is going to exist for a very short term here. And frequency stability is going to exist for, it's going to exist for a both long term and short term. It is going to exist for both long term and short term here. And voltage stability is of two category: large disturbance voltage stability and small disturbance voltage stability. Here both categories under voltage stability is going to exist for short term also, and going to exist for long term. Both your large disturbance voltage stability as well as your small disturbance voltage stability. First, let me see what you mean by rotor angle stability. It's nothing but when there is a sudden change in load, the rotor angle is going to shift into a new position, which results in rotor angle stability, rotor angle disturbances. Here, to overcome that, we use the concept rotor angle stability. It refers to the ability of synchronous machines of an interconnected power system to remain in synchronism after being subjected to disturbance. Synchronism nothing means when you go for a parallel operation of generators or alternators. All the alternates have which is synchronized to same voltage, same sequence. Hence, sudden change in load, which results short circuit, which result in disturbance in that, which result in loss of synchronism. Similarly, also rotor angle instability occurs due to angular swings of some generators, leading to their loss of synchronism with other generators. Depending on the ability to maintain or restore equilibrium between electromagnetic torque and mechanical torque of each synchronous machine. Rotor angle stability again is classified into small disturbance and large disturbance rotor angle stability. In small disturbance rotor angle stability, it is the ability of power system to maintain synchronism under small disturbance. Okay, when there is a very small disturbance, automatically it will be taken care under this type of rotor angle stability. It doesn't have that much effect in the power system as well as to the component which is connected. Disturbances are considered to be sufficiently very small such that the linear system equations is permissible for purpose of analysis. As already given in this point, the time frame of interest in small disturbance stability studies, they around 10 to 20 seconds following a disturbance. Only going to exist for only this, and then the system becomes stable. Under large disturbance, it is the ability of power system to maintain synchronous under a severe disturbance such as short circuit. Short circuit is very severe, hence the system to be made stable. That is, we are called a large disturbance rotor angle stability. The next category will be voltage stability. Voltage refers to the ability of power system to maintain steady voltage at all buses in the system after being subjected to a disturbance from a given initial operating condition. What it says here? Ability of power system to maintain steady voltage at all buses. Okay, there are three buses in a three-phase, three-wire system. Voltage must remain same after synchronization. It should not, there may be increase or decrease in the voltage on the bus bar. A system voltage is instable in for at least one bus in the system. The voltage magnitude decreases as reactive power injection is increased. Voltage instability results in progressive fall or rise of voltage of some buses. And this to be made stable, that result in voltage stability. The next category under that one is frequency stability. Refers to ability of power system to maintain steady frequency following a severe system upset, resulting in a significant imbalance in between generation and load. Frequency instability leads to tripping of generating units or load. Frequency stability may be a short-term phenomenon or may be a long-term. In both the cases, which results in what? Tripping of generating units and or loads to be taken care, which makes it frequency stability. And finally, under classification of stability, we conclude that power system is always required for normal and stable operation at rated operating condition, and it's also required to improvement of stability. Stability of power system is improved by using shunt and series capacitor governing system and FACTS controllers. Reduced transmission losses. Power is generated by renewable energy source and create a power park.